The exit process itself will have to take place over a very short period of time. I think the best way of thinking about it is a weekend. Mm-hmm. That's to say, an announcement is made on the Friday night. There's a brief, markets are closed over that period. The banks are shut, cash machines are shut. There's a brief period in which the monetary leadership, the governor, the central bank, the finance minister, whoever else is involved, can talk about these issues with other senior people, both in the government and outside the government, talk to MPs, talk to opposition leaders, discuss it. But this is not going to be something that will be capable of being overturned. The point is to talk to these people in order to try to bring them on board. But by the time that the markets are fully open and you can access banks in the normal way, it must be a done deal. Now, that could be Monday, or it may well be that you have to have a couple of normally working days, Monday and Tuesday, with the banks still closed before you reopen on Wednesday. Mm-hmm. But the process itself must take just a matter of days. I think there's no doubt that countries can leave the euro, and this has been, I think, the great contribution of the Wolfson Prize, because for so many years, one of the replies of people who wanted the euro to stay together was that it was actually impossible for it to be taken apart. Now, we've known throughout economic history there have been all sorts of arrangements which are supposedly permanent and turn out not to be, but there are particular aspects of the euro issue which make it tricky, in particular the legal status of the euro and the difficulties that might be encountered by a country leaving it in a legal sense. There's no doubt whatsoever that the whole process can be done, and we've laid down essentially a blueprint for how a government can think about leaving the euro. That being the case, it's then down to them and to others to think through whether it's actually a good thing to leave the euro. That's one issue. Can it be done? That's not an issue. It most certainly can be done. I think if a country were to leave the euro, the main beneficiaries would be all those people in that country who are currently unemployed or suffering massively from the appalling economic performance. Greece at the moment is suffering a loss of GDP from the peak of something like 17%, and by the end of next year it may well be 25%. That's roughly equal to the loss of GDP that America and Germany suffered in the 1930s. There are huge numbers of ordinary people who bear that loss. Unemployed people, particularly young people, can't get jobs. People who are scavenging in the streets of Athens to get food. These are going to be the main beneficiaries of a policy which releases them from this straitjacket, condemns them to years and years of depression. I'm just over the moon about winning the prize. It's always nice, of course, to win, but in this particular case, I guess it's been very special because you don't know what, when you enter, you don't know what the whole exercise is. And I had to, as it were, gird my loins and other people in the firm to persuade them that this was something worth doing, because, you know, you there may be thousands of entries, you may end up being number 101 or 2001, you just don't know. You have to put in an awful lot of effort, and unlike most ordinary business activity, you've got no sense whatsoever that you're going to get any return from it. So it really is a leap in the dark. So to make that leap in the dark and then actually to win, frankly, I'm just over the moon.
Excellent. Okay.
Perfect. Absolutely.
You've got all the material.
Absolutely, yeah. We'll just edit you out, put some title screens in with your questions.